So there was a Boosie badass, like staying on the Lori Harvey topic.
Yeah. I'm glad you said it. So I wanted to bring that shit up.
Yeah, he was saying that we shouldn't give credit to the woman when she dates a lot of guys. We should give credit to the guy who, I guess, like calms her down or settles her down. Or he was basically talking about Lori Harvey like she was cattle.
Understand why he keeps trying to give advice like Boosie is like the savior. Like, we don't care what he has to say. Like, I don't understand why isn't like he was offended that he sees a girl doing what guys do all the time.
Because he hates women.
There we go.
This is Boosie's quote. We got to start giving the bachelors, the men who are running through a beautiful woman like this, the credit. Who not housing her, running through her.
The scariest thing is that he has kids.
A lot of them.
And they're going to probably be just like him.
A lot of them. What do you think, Christy? What do you think about Boosie badass, Boosie's comments?
I don't really care for it.
I
also know that he's saying... I know that he's saying these things because even though it's like, who cares what he says? But people are reposting it. And people are spreading it around. So mm-hmm. he's getting the attention that he wants. Whether we think that it's a big thing or not, like even the fact that we're talking about it today, right now, like this is what he wants. So, I mean, at some level, I guess we do care. But I feel like, just like you guys said, like this man has multiple children and didn't he get shot in the leg? Shouldn't he be worrying about that healing? Wasn't he in a wheelchair?
Yeah, he was shot in the leg. Right? Somebody shot him in the leg. I think he shot him in the leg.
I'm sorry about that.
Either he gets shot in the leg or the ass. One of those two.
He needs to be get shot in the ass. No, let me take that back. Nobody deserves to get shot. But he... Doesn't he do music?
He's a rapper. He raps.
He's a rapper.
Like, I even got that. I said he do music. Like, I don't even know what he does. I don't remember last time I heard a Boosie track anyway, but...
I mean, I think
he's
just
because all he's doing is on Instagram and his own little opinions, and they get spread throughout the media, social media. So, does anyone even know any of his songs right now?
I couldn't.
Song out right now.
There was a gun to my head, and you asked me to name a Boosie badass song. It's Lights Out for me. Mm-hmm. He also like made a comment about Lori Harvey's body count. How do you guys feel about men that judge women and talk about body counts?
You insecure. Because everybody has a pass.
Indeed.
The guy got a pass too. So I'm like, how you gonna judge me? You didn't think I was doing anything back in the day? Like you had a life. You were
guys
doing
don't
stuff.
Guys don't have a pass. What are you talking about?
What? Oh, I didn't know.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm joking. Comedy. I'm joking.
Okay, don't. Like, don't get me started.
No.
Yeah, everybody has a past, so you can't be upset at somebody's body count because there was somebody before you.
There was. What do you think, Christy? How should guys navigate this, or should we not at all?
I just feel like it's none of their business. It is none of their business. They are never going to be able to even touch Lori Harvey. Like, why y'all worry about her body count? Why you guys worry about how many? She's not gonna be around yours. Like,
that's
what does that have to do
point.
With your life? You know,
that is
like, what does who she's dating today, yesterday, tomorrow have to do with you? Like, I don't get it.
Yeah, no, Boosie is. I feel like there are a bunch of like guys in hip hop or just in entertainment in general that secretly hate women, and secretly hate when a woman does well or. When a woman is smarter than them or is better at something than them. And that is an indication of extreme insecurity, an extreme, you know, lack of self-esteem. I don't care about, in fact, let me say this the right way so that I'm honest and not PC. A woman's body count is not my business, right? If I'm with somebody, the only business I have, you know, concerning them and their body and what they do with it is if, you know, we decide that we're going to be monogamous and we're going to be together and only with each other. Other than that, I don't have any control over that. I don't have any right to question or judge anything that happened before me. I do find it difficult, though, to date a woman who's been with multiple friends that I know. And I feel like moving in the same circles like that as a woman or as a man can be messy.
Yes.
That makes sense.
But it's more socially acceptable for a guy to do it as opposed to a woman doing it. Like if a guy does it, it's him like conquering this group of women, whether it's like a group of women that go to the same school or at his job. I've heard things like that. It's not what I've done. I'm very, very brought up the right way. But like if a woman does it, then she's like a homie hopper or she's a hoe or she's this or she's that. Boosie should not be concerned about anybody's body count. Like no rapper that has no rapper like him who's like paid for pussy his entire career should be worried about anybody's body count. Because that's what most rappers do, is pay for pussy.
I feel like it's both ways. If a guy is fucking multiple, like has had sex with multiple girls, multiple women that are similar friends, he's a hoe. They're like, oh, he's a hoe. He did her too. Same way that guys categorize it and say like when they've done multiple women that mm-hmm. are friends or whatever. And then, I mean, I'm sorry, if the girl has had sex with multiple guys and then she's considered a hoe, but it's a group of friends that like similar guys who's like, oh yeah, I had sex with her too. I think it's both ways. But you're a hoe. When you do it with friends, then that's when it gets tricky. I feel like if you had sex with multiple people, I mean, that's just you having a body count. That's normal. Life. Yeah.
That's life too.
But when it becomes right? friends and like, yeah, when it becomes friends and stuff, then that just gets really tricky.
Or cousins. Yeah, that's bad too.
Yeah, family too. Yeah, that gets real awkward. Like, oh, hey, from the barbecue. Oh, that's oh, hey, we got to talk real quick.
We all know him. That's crazy. Yeah, that can be really messy. But I just don't feel like any guy should be worried about like what a woman did before him, as long as she's not, you know, bringing along any features or anything from other relationships that could, you know, require prescription. So other than that, you know,
as long as you're healthy, that's good.
As long as you're healthy, it's good. But I do have to ask you guys, just because like I have women here and I hardly ever do. A guy tells you he's been with like 1,400 women. If you ask him, hey, what's your body count? I've been with 1,400 women. How you guys feel about that?
When did you find the time?
1,400 is really like 25,000.
25,000? No, if he says like he's been keeping count.
Yeah, because
so if he says 1,400, no, like, it's probably
1,600. They have sex with one person. They have sex with that one person of the 1,400. And that one person has sex with 8 people. That means that he has sex with 9 people just off that one person. Did you guys know that?
I'm getting a flashback to health class.
Right? Not going to listen to this. Wait, so I do.
Yes, I mean,
girl, don't count.
I just got to rethink my whole life right now. But what do you guys think? Like, you ask me, hey, what's your body count? I've been with 1,400 women. Like, how are you guys handling that? Like, are you saying, hey, you can be my man?
I need to see like your results from your last like you know checkup.
Let's say everything is above board. He's healthy.
I kind of want to see a list of positions that you've done with these 1,400 women, just to see like how you know how much you've been doing. It doesn't bother me.
Okay.
As long as you're healthy and everything, that's not a big deal.
1,400 women. What do you say to that, Christy? I've been with dude's been with 1,400 women.
I can't say that I wouldn't feel away.
Mm-hmm.
But I would still be with the person.
Okay.
Because that's their past. And indeed. Hopefully, I mean, it kind of shows a lot, and you try not to be judgmental because then it's like, oh, you a hoe. You're like,
that's your first initial thought, right?
You know?
Yeah.
Wait, 1,400. Like, first of all, why are you counting past 20? At like, how do you have 1,400?
He has a notebook.
Damn, like, this is a game. No, like this is a real game to you. Like,
yeah, if you can count up to 1,400, it's like notches on your belt.
Yeah, this is a real game. Like, this is game of life.
That's just like 50 Kims That's at least like 30 Ashleys. Like 17
Christinas. I would ask like silly questions. I probably would ask like, have you had sex with the person with the same name or like the same last names or like.
Yeah. I mean, never mind. I'm just going to give away way too much information about myself. They probably had
sex with at least 200 betas.
Wait, quick question. Trevor, if a girl, now vice versa, if a woman has told you she's been with 1,400 people, are you dating her or are you just like, no?
I'm going to be completely honest. Probably not.
Why is that always the thing with guys? Like, I feel like even if like a woman's number is higher than the guy's number, if that comes up, then they just be like, they look at the woman so differently. Like, you shouldn't have a higher number than me, or like, I feel like women get judged for how many people we sleep with.
Most guys do that. I don't consider myself a guy that does that, but I don't know, man. I think it's a double edged sword, right? Because as guys, sometimes we don't like, you know, share the same standards when it comes to ourselves and for women, which is fucked up. And then we also think about, it's weird because like as guys, we think about ourselves in such this like deprecating negative light, because it's like certain times, like you might have a male friend and you want to be like, oh, that's my guy, Jamal. Nah, Jamal wants to fuck. And we know that because we know guys and we know how like primal some guys are. So us thinking about all those 1,400 primal guys with this person that I'm about to date, like, are you friends with any of them? Like, are any of them still in your life? Like, 1,400 people, it's a very small chance that none of these niggas are in your life anymore. Very minute chance, just by numbers-wise, like, just, like, by pure math. So for me, I don't know if it's something that I could do when it comes to like the number 1,400, that's a lot of time on your back. I don't know, like,
not necessarily. There's different positions.
There are different positions, but I don't know. I know I sound really misogynistic at this.
No, that's what guys go. But it's just interesting though, because then guys want us to do all the stuff in the bedroom, but they want us to have a low number count. But it's funny. It is kind of
no. I want all the stuff in the bedroom. So like I don't know. There's a certain point where it's not cool to want to be with somebody that ain't been with nobody. Because like you gotta work it out some way. You warm before you work out, right?
Yeah.
Your little dynamic warm-up in, and then you work out. Like there's no just jumping into the workout because you're gonna pull something.
That's true.
Isn't it fun warm enough?
Sometimes the warm-up is horrible. A lot of times the warm-up is horrible. Like the first time you do anything is not the best. It's not.
Yeah, you learn from it.
You learn.
Yeah, but like second, third time.
You make your mistakes. You find out what people like, what they don't like. You find out that things in movies don't work in real life. And then you and then you're better for it.
Not sure.
You know, one thing I can say is that even though I just said, yeah, I would be with someone, like, especially if they're clean, like, I would be with someone, but it would make me question so much. And not only, like, about them, but just make me question myself. Like, then it's like, you have to be a very secure bitch to be with someone that was like that. Because then you really have to, because it makes you wonder, just like that one question, are those people still in your life?
Mm-hmm.
Were they better than me? Am I the best you've had?
Or
the
worst question is,
they do?
The worst question is like if a guy has been with 1,400 women, there's a couple women that he got with that look just like Eddie Murphy. Just like Eddie Murphy. Or Dave Chappelle.
I agree with Chris. I agree with you guys on that. With are they still in your life? That's probably the main question I need to ask.
Yeah.
I don't need to see these people pop every 5 minutes. Like, are y'all friends or are y'all like trying to rekindle something? Like, what's mm-hmm. happening here? That's my main question, is that because people be holding on to the past and like the past is in the past for a reason. Like, you keep trying to bring the past to your future, you're going to be stuck in your past.
Yeah. But I think that's a thing. But it's like also, Chris, to what you're saying, is like, you probably think, even as a guy, like if you were the guy and she's been with like 1,400 women, you're like, am I as fly as I need to be? Or was I just at the right place at the right time? Yeah. Like, was
yes,
I just here?
Exactly.
Was it I just breathing on two legs? Like, was it like, what are your standards? What are your requirements?
And it's
you have them?
It's so unfortunate.
Yeah.
Exactly. That it makes you question yourself, which is sad. Like, and it's sad that to think that way, but I don't know. I'm not the most secure person. So that's like instantly like, yeah, I like him. So I'm going to be with him. But then I'm also like, damn, like, what does that say about me?
What stands out about
me? Am I desperate?
As opposed to like the other 1400 like people you were with, right? Like it's a weird dynamic.
Yeah. Okay. So you just want me because I have a pussy. Oh, okay.
You know, and that's the thing. That's the thing that I guess is tough when it comes to like being with multiple people. Like I don't even think it's like the negative part of thinking about how easily this person was accessible. It's like, what were your standards, and do I live up to them?
Yeah.
Do your standards exist?
That's yeah. Like, do you have standards, or you just kind of just go with it? Like, okay, we hang exactly. out, fuck you, same night. Like, I need the standards thing and. Are you still in contact with the people? Those would be my main concerns. Because
indeed, yeah. And they shouldn't be in contact with former sexual partners.
No,
it's not okay. Indeed.